Hi guys, this is Miss McCarthy. Nice to meet you. Welcome to trimester three of mythology. So, obviously, we're gonna be doing a lot of videos. We don't know how long this is gonna last, or really what our rest of our school year looks like. So I will be doing videos for as long as we are going to be doing online schooling. So you'll see a video posted almost every day just to give you a short explanation of what you're going to be doing today and what is expected of you for the week. This will usually be probably about a 10-day process for each unit. We are going to have 6 units in mythology and then a final project, which is going to be a combination of all the units. But let's get started just with simple introductions. I really want to get to know you guys, so if you want to send me an email introducing yourself, that would be great. If not, I think we're going to have an activity which will give you a great opportunity to post your picture or a video, whichever you prefer, introducing yourself to the class. All right? That is not what I wanted to do. Right. So, made a little introduction presentation for you guys. Sorry, you guys are having to deal with this. All right, so I'm Miss McCarthy. Who am I? Well, I'm Miss McCarthy. Here's my email, easy access, any questions you may have, any concerns, and then of course when you're sharing your projects with me, this might be where it goes, but I'm also going to have a Google Classroom, which I will share with you guys in the upcoming days. Hopefully by the time you view this video, you'll already have access to your Google Classroom. But we will see how it goes. I will be sending those codes as soon as possible. I have a Bachelor of Arts in English from Stevens Point, UW Stevens Point. Some of you might be familiar with that. And then I have a master's in secondary education from Grand Canyon University. I did that online when I was getting my teacher certification as well. Right, my hobbies. I love to write, which I know very stereotypical maybe of an English teacher, but I'm very into writing, and I'm actually currently working on a novella, which is a shorter version of a novel. And then I love to read everything I do. I love learning about so many different topics, so I go from fiction to nonfiction, back and forth all the time. I am currently reading the nonfiction biography about the Apollo 13 event. If you guys aren't familiar with that, look it up. It's very cool and very interesting. So I'm currently reading that for nonfiction, and for fiction, I'm not currently reading anything so right now. And then, of course, you'll see here that my favorite book series is Harry Potter. Big nerd. I love it. I grew up with it, and I'm still obsessed with it to this day. Fun facts: I was born in Germany. My parents were both in the Air Force for 20 years each, and so my older sister, was born in the Philippines, and then 4 years later, I was born in Germany. So that is a very fun thing to share and fun thing to be a part of. And then I have a cat named Minion. You'll see her here. You see my cursor. That I call her Minnie though, but I used to love those yellow Minion things from Despicable Me when I got her about 5 years ago. And she was therefore named after them. But I call her Minnie because she was the runt of the litter. And then, like I said, I'm a huge Harry Potter nerd, so you'll see me here. This is after I got my bachelor's degree, and my family went to Florida to go to Disney and the Wizarding World of Harry Potter, which was pretty much the coolest experience ever. And for those of you who are curious, I am Slytherin. That's the house that I have placed myself in. If any other Harry Potter nerds out there, please share with that. I would love to learn your houses. That's the best way I learn about people, is what houses I would place them in, or what they place themselves in. So please share. So that's just my short little introduction about me. Let's get into what mythology is and what you will be doing. So first, you'll see here that I have class expectations. Obviously, class expectations change for online schooling, So I will go over class expectations in the actual classroom if we end up coming back, which hopefully we will, and I'll go over those expectations there with you guys. But for classroom expectations for online schooling, really, I just ask you guys to let me know if you have questions or concerns, and to watch these videos and to be working on your unit project so you don't get behind. Any of you who know anybody who was in my MIP class last trimester know that may talk to them and say, hey, I regret not doing my unit projects when I had the time because they rushed to do the unit projects at the end and they didn't really get good scores on them because they didn't work as hard as they should have. I'll go into more about those projects in a bit. So those are my classroom expectations really for online schooling, is that you watch my videos that I post daily or sometimes bi-daily, and that you follow the instructions and you do what is expected of you for this course and get those assignments into classroom by the due dates. Daily vocabulary notes. You can put these in your notebook or in a Google Docs. I recommend Google Docs just because that'll be easier to turn in, especially if we stay online for the rest of the trimester. I'm going to need to see those notes eventually. Those notes will also have quizzes with them every 5 to 10 words. Mostly they'll just be words that show or have a connection to mythology and legends that we use today. So we'll be starting that in our first class, technically, quote unquote, tomorrow. So look into that, and I will make a video with those vocabulary words giving you the definition, and then those definition quizzes, or they might also be put into sentences. So try to put words into sentences where they fit. Those quizzes will be every 5 to 10 words. Okay, so what is mythology and legends? Mythology, legends, world. That's what this course is. So, what is it? Mythology and legends, they're pretty much tales which were told for the following reasons. One, to explain a natural event. This natural event could be weather, the creation of Earth, which will be our first unit. Animals. Animals being such as why certain animals are enemies, or why a squirrel has a stripe down its back, or what else? Why childbirth is painful. If you guys are, any of you guys are Catholic out there, you'll realize that is a reference to the Adam and Eve story from the Bible, which we will be referencing some biblical stories because that is part of mythology, legends, and world readings, texts. So that moves us on to religious beliefs. While it could be the Bible, it could also be for gods and goddesses, for Greek mythology, because those myths were created for religious beliefs that they believed in multiple gods. And some still do, but that was more back in ancient times. But right now, they're more of mythology. However, they use those gods to explain who is in control of certain events and why certain things occurred, such as the seasons, which would be the Persephone and Hades mythology, which we will get into later as well. Entertainment. A lot of stories were just told, especially orally, which means they were told by word of mouth, not written down, just to pass on and entertain each other. Things got bored. There was no TV, and while they might have had certain sporting events that they created themselves, they had to fill the night somehow without TV and video games. All right? So they told stories to entertain each other. And so a lot of these stories were created just for entertainment. So what will we be doing in this class? It's mostly project-based, so you'll have a lot of work time, creative project, and a reflection. So each unit, you will be working on a project that reflects the actual unit. We'll go over the units in the next slide. So each unit, you'll have a creative project, and then you'll reflect on that creative project and how whatever you did for the creative project reflects what the unit was, is, or was. So a lot of times you'll be doing a reading, and you could, for instance, choose to use your creative project as a drawing. So you could draw a picture of what you read and then do a reflection on it. The reflection is the main source of your point, so you will have to go into depth. I will be making a video for the next slide that will show you exactly what I want for your creative project and what I expect for that, but also what I expect for your reflection. So pay attention to those videos because I will tell you exactly what you need to get full points. Movies and readings. So while the first unit's not going to really have movies, it's more going to have clips. The rest of the units, I will play two movies each. I'm pretty sure I can play that on the screen even if we're doing this online. So we should be able to do that with this screen sharing app that I have. So hopefully that'll work out. And you guys will take notes and we'll reflect on how those movies connect back to what unit we are on. And then, of course, we'll have readings. Those readings will be what you use as reference for your creative project and for your reflection. I'll also be doing at the beginning of every unit a reading of one of these readings for the unit that we're on, just so that you get kind of an idea of what a story for that unit would look like. And also so that you guys have an idea. If you don't like the list of the ones I give you, you can look up your own and know what you're looking for when you choose a story. But I will be giving you guys pretty comprehensive lists and links to stories that you can be reading for these projects. All right, so trimester breakdown. First unit, creation stories. Second unit, hero's journey. Unit three, the lover's journey. Unit four, when journeys collide, which is conflict. Unit five, journey into the unknown. Unit six, journey for others, which is usually about self-sacrifice. And then the final project, which will kind of be a combination of all units and the creative projects that you did for that, plus a final reflection. If we're back into the actual classroom by then, I will have sort of like an art show gallery set up that you guys can present your final projects to me as I go around, kind of like a museum. But if we are not back by the end of the trimester and we do this entire trimester online, obviously I'll set it up a little differently and we'll do worry about that then, okay? So that is your breakdown of what mythology and legends is going to look like this trimester. It's really exciting. It's probably my favorite subject to teach. So I'm really excited to be working on this with you guys. So if you have any questions, concerns, comments, please email me. I will be getting you guys the classroom link as soon as possible. And so that you can, by the time you see this video, you should be having access to Classroom. So, because this video will be posted within that. So, that is the end of this first video. I hope that you will be ex as excited as I am to work on this course together, okay? All right.